Hi there. This video will outline one way to delete rows based on a cell value in a spreadsheet. Here we have a file that contains trade data of fictional public companies, which are listed down the page of our worksheet. However, let's say we only want to present those securities which have realized a change in market value, as witnessed in column I. Sure, we can filter out zeros based on column I, but this might be a menial task that I need to do daily and with a number of worksheets. Therefore, we will explore a simple VBA macro which will automate this process and could save you a lot of time, especially over a working week or year. We need to insert a module firstly. Give your macro a concise yet self-explanatory name. I am naming this Delete Zero Rows. In most cases, it's wise to disable the three key Excel features of calculation, enable events, and screen updating. Next, it is a good habit to declare the variables for the macro, as this will improve the code's efficiency and help to avert runtime errors. The visual basic data type long, as in long integer, is applied to delete row because it will mitigate against integer numbers that are too large to fit in the integer data type. In other words, if we are wanting to apply this macro on a large data set, the long data type will work error-free. Now we will set our objects. In the case of the worksheet object WS, you need to be aware this macro will run on any worksheet. If you want to restrict it to a certain worksheet, then you would want to explicitly state that, i.e. use Sheet 1 or Sheet 2 instead of Active Sheet. We can now write out the loop, which will run through our data range and rows containing zeros in column I. Although adding comments may seem a waste of time, they can be worthwhile if we ever need to troubleshoot or review the macro in the future. We will employ the for loop. Further, we want this macro to be able to dynamically run across data sets of different ranges. Hence the use of row.count and the end xlup.row syntax. remember, whenever you use the range.end property and Excel up, the macro will run and start at the top of the range and loop down the range of data, which in this case is by each row. Next, we need to clarify on what row the macro will start from, which in this case will be from row 5, because we clearly want to preserve the information in rows 1 to 4. Hence, we use the integer 5 in our code, as this will ensure the macro starts on row 5. As this description states, we need to identify any cells in column I which are 0 and instruct the loop to delete the entire row. We can use a simple if statement. To delete the entire row, you must state this in your macro. Now we need to instruct the macro, after we have completed the if statement, to move to the next cell in the range. Otherwise, the loop of our data range won't work. This is simply the insertion of the next syntax, which is mandatory for a for loop. Our loop is complete, and we can re-enable those Excel features which were disabled at the top of our code. Let's save our macro and try the macro on our data set. As mentioned, we want this macro to delete any row which contains a 0 in the column I range. Let's insert a form control or macro button at the top of the sheet and assign our newly created macro, delete 0 rows. We'll quickly name our macro button, which will be self-evident to other users of our financial model. Once we have saved it, let's run the macro and identify how any 0 cells in column I will trigger the deletion of that entire row from our worksheet.